It's news time. Information is power. The Current. The news headline. IPOB flees Buhari stand on Kano. The news in full. The Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB, has condemned President Muhammadu Buhari's use stand in considering a political solution for the release of its leader, Mazen of the Kano. IPOB, in a statement by its media and publicity secretary, Imam Powerful, attributed the president's shift to misinformation by sacked members of the group who they alleged were feeding the president with wrong information. And see that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu should not be released, claiming erroneously though that IPOB and ESN has been defeated, which is a lie. We want to tell Buhari and his court that he is going to make a mistake capable of consuming Nigeria should he fail to release Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, because this bunch of criminals he had meeting with were only giving him incorrect information about the Indigenous People of Biafra and also the ESN outfit. His actions. It should be remembered that Kanu, the leader of the Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB, is facing treason accusations brought against him by the federal government. And this was the reason why President Muhammadu Buhari was asked during an exclusive interview with Channels TV. He had said that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu would actually not be released and should account for everything he had said while outside the country. And this was made known why Buhari said that it was a difficult decision for him just to, you know, say that he would release Mazen Nnamdi Kanu when he has not realized that what he did was wrong and that no political solution will be addressed, can be used, saying that he would actually, you know, allow the legislative, the judiciary rather, to do their work, because one thing that one office arm that he respects and does not want to interfere into is the judiciary. Those people of Biafra leader Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, while speaking, Abubakar Malami made it known that the president will continue to consider the interest of over 200 Nigerians before he can think of releasing Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. It could be recalled that the former aviation minister Mbazulike Amechi actually went with the elders of the Southeast to meet President Muhammadu Buhari, you know, for to seek the release of Nnamdi Kanu. However, it was actually said, you know, by the Attorney General of the Federation as at then, that a political solution can actually, you know, foster the release of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. But now, it is obvious that the Abubakar Malami has a vital point here, that the interest, you know, of Nigerians, you know, should be considered first before doing anything. And then these IPOB members are truly, you know, Nigerian citizens, and their interest as well should be considered, because if it can happen to Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, it can happen to anybody. And the interest of Nigerians, you know, must truly be considered first. But nevertheless, you know, one has to still chill and wait to see what will happen in this year 2022, as the Indigenous People of Biafra had actually said that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu must be released this year. Challenges. Kanu stated that the action of the defendant on a solitary confinement is inhumane, degrading, and constitutes a breach of Section 34 of the 1999 Constitution. He wants the court to declare that the respondent, while carrying out their duties, are to abide by Chapter 4 of the 1999 Constitution. Kanu is praying the court to declare that he is entitled to the enjoyment of his rights to dignity of human person as enshrined under Section 34 of the 1999 Constitution. He also wants the court to order the respondents to immediately allow him appoint legal practitioners and medical personnel of his choice from any government hospital to review his health file. Kanu equally wants the court to direct his movement from solitary confinement to where he would be allowed, you know, to pray and practice his faith unhindered in line with constitutional provisions. And this was the agitation of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, who is at the DSS facility, saying that he, you know, after the court had said that he be allowed to be in the DSS facility with enough attention and comfortability, and he should be given everything needed there, and sees that
in the suit filed by his lawyer Maxwell Okwara says before the High Court that he's still denied of food and medical care, clothes of his choice, and tried to practice his religion. Also saying that Mazen Abekanu claimed that the doctor that has been attending to him is a quack doctor and not experienced.
After I read the report in Tribune newspaper where the Imo State governor said this, I thought it would be nice to take a look at the present situation of the country to know if Hope Uzodinma is right by that statement. Despite COVID-19 pandemic, Nigeria was able to come out of recession. Hope Uzodinma believes that Buhari has done well by moving the country out of the recession, despite the COVID-19 pandemic that was ravaging the whole country. But some people will disagree with Uzodinma because the cost of living is high, which is a clear sign that people cannot feel the impact of the recession which the country has exited. For example, the cost of cooking gas has tripled and the value of Naira is reducing by day. Also, many Nigerians are beginning to wonder how things will be if the federal government removes subsidy by the middle of next year. In addition, the insecurity in northern Nigeria has made it impossible, you know, for farmers to go to the farm, and the consequence is an increase in food commodities like onion, yam, and tomato. I want to believe that Hope Uzodinma made a political statement because ordinary Nigerians who are battling hardship will disagree with him that Nigerians are happy with the president. People are joining the APC. What some people will ask is if joining the APC is a yardstick to measure the rate at which people are happy with the president. Uzodinma forgot that ordinary Nigerians who struggle by day are after survival and not political power. It is common sense to say that people who join the APC at this time looking ahead of the 2023 general election. While Uzodinma is entitled to his opinion, I doubt if ordinary Nigerians who are complaining of the high cost of living will agree with him that people are happy with President Muhammadu Buhari, and that is why the APC is welcoming new members. This may be outrightly wrong, saying that the people are joining APC because they are happy with President Muhammadu Buhari, looking at the adverse effect of the COVID-19 pandemic and also the clear sign of impact of the recession which the country had just exited, where the cost of food, gas, and many others are just so high that Nigerians are beginning to wonder if the federal government, you know, would actually increase yet again, remove yet again the subsidy and the adverse effect on the Nigerian populace.
Next Saturday to witness the presentation of a classic book written by Governor Hope Uzodinma. The book, titled Reflections on the Igbo Question, is a bold attempt to situate the marginalization of Igbo in Project Nigeria and how best to overcome it.
Thanks for listening, and that is the news.